explain for you.
Okay, so it's right. We have certainly sent it down in Arabic Quran so that you can understand. So in other words, in order for us to understand the Quran, what language must we use according to the Quran? Yeah. Arabic.
Because they were Arabs, it came to.
Okay, fine.
But Allah knew in his great plan it's going to trouble
right.
the world.
So you're right. But now I'm saying to you, you're absolutely right. So we have to use the principles of Arabic in order to understand this verse. Okay. We're not, no hadith. Please. Don't tell me anything about hadith. I'm making it so clear. I'm putting the hadith to the side now.
Only if that was true.
Go please, on. Don't say that because it's annoying. I'm saying no hadith. Yeah. I'm not using any hadith here. I'm saying, was Qurnan, first word, talking to the woman, the wife of the Prophet, and mentioned, مَا يُتْلَى فِي بِيُوتِكُمْ whatever is mentioned in your homes, مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ from the ayat of Allah, وَالْحِكْمَةِ and the hikmah, which is the wisdom.
Yeah.
Okay.
I agree with that.
Now, in Arabic, I've said to you before, when the well is a letter, well is a conjunctive letter, yeah? It puts two things which are different from each other next to each other. You cannot say two things are the same and put them two together. It doesn't work in Arabic. It doesn't even work in English. You can't say Cameron went to the park. It just doesn't make any sense.
Unless it's two different cameras.
Yeah, unless it's two different cameras,
yeah,
right?
This is, I agree with you. We're coming back to the same part of what I said to
please,
you before.
Please.
You can only get
just let me finish, please. You've got to now, because the Quran, now it's going to come to you, either accept or reject it. Now, if I say, I was riding a bike in a bike, does that make sense?
No. See,
no, okay, fine.
Let's talk about the Quran.
Okay, I'm saying, even in English it doesn't make sense, let alone Arabic.
No, talk about the Quran.
Fine. So here, there's an instruction from Allah to the women who are the wives of the Prophet to recite the ayat of Allah, which are the verses of Allah, and recite something else. Or mention something else.
No, translate it word for word.
Wadhkurna.
No, Arabic, not Arabic, English.
Wadhkurna, word for word. Wadhkurna. And you women folk, ma yutla, what is recited, fi biyutikunna, in your houses, min ayatillahi, from the ayat of Allah, wal hikmah, and the wisdom.
And the wisdom.
Okay.
And this is where we disagree now.
Okay, now please.
Because I said
what
to
I'm saying
the,
is,
the hikmah
but now you have to do
comes from the Quran.
Okay, listen, I don't disagree so far, but what I'm saying is not the same thing as the Quran.
This is.
Okay, now you've committed a fallacy.
No, I haven't, because you can only get the you can only get the hikmah from the Quran. You believe in the
Anyways,
if you believe in the oneness of Allah and you believe
I'm telling you in Arabic language, it's impossible.
Forget about the language.
We're talking about hikmah here.
I'm telling you, for you to get the hikmah of the Quran, you have to believe in every word that is said in there, and you have to apply it. And when the Creator tells you, let me finish. When the Creator says that this is the book that's going to guide you to heaven, yes, and you're going to follow the footsteps of the Prophet, and you believe in the unseen, that everything in this book is here.
But how do you know something?
You believe in that, then you'll get the hikmah from the Quran, then the wisdom will come.
Anyways,
the wisdom will
come. I can't do it.
Because I'm not a Christian.
Forget about Arabic, even though using a translation.
No, because you're trying to legitimize your understanding your hadith, because you need to understand the Arabic language.
He's talking about the hadith. He's using the Quran. And you're using your own idea.
In the same breath you say that the Quran is preserved. In the same breath you say, well, no, it's not preserved because you need the Arabic language.
I said, did I once say that it's not preserved?
You're saying it without saying it. That's what I'm saying.
I mean, according to you, that's what it is. But you saying that the Quran is not preserved without realizing. That's what I'm saying.
I'm saying the Quran is
preserved. Yeah, nice one. Well done. Great interview, mate.
This
has
got to be a first time that you've run away from someone.
Yeah, you done well. You stood up for yourself and you backed yourself up.
Well, yeah, I know verses.
Oh, that's fair.
They cannot, you know, it's easy for them to overpower people that have not read the scripture.
Yeah, exactly.
I've read it.
So
now, they're mixing truth with falsehood. Now they're trying to legitimize their belief with more falsehood. How can you do that? Use the book itself to explain itself, and it does that. There'd be no, there'd be, it's, there'd be no trouble in the world. Muslims won't be in any trouble if they follow the scripture.
Instead of going back to everything else.
There'd be no Sunnis, there'd be no Wahhabis, there'd be none of this concept. We'd be exactly the same.
With the classical.
Yeah, we just have little differences, little silly understandings.
Which is enough.
But we won't be violent, we won't be aggressive, we won't be demonic, we won't be satanic, we won't be nothing negative.
Yeah, and trying to get everyone on our side to this side, pulling each other around.
Absolutely.
What is your name anyway, mate?
Cameron.
Cameron, nice one. Good stuff, mate. Pleasure to meet you. Pleasure.
So, I guess that you've been here for a while.
I come down and do a few films here.
So you must see quite a few battles, as they say.
There's some good ones. So Muhammad's involved in a few of them.
I know. I see sometimes on YouTube. So what would you rank this one out of 10?
It was a good debate. 10 out of 10 for the debate. He was trying to put a few things over. You were trying to put a few things over.
He wasn't taking any notice of what I was saying. That's the feeling that I got from him.
Because
he's quite learned.
No, he is. But when it comes up on the video, and he might see it on his own mind, then he might consider a few things later.
Yeah.
Good points that you made.
Yeah.
And he made a few good points.
Yeah.
So.
Absolutely.
It's less nice to have that mix, and then we can make a judgment.
Yeah. I look forward to it.
Nice, man. Excellent. Good stuff, Cameron. All the best to you, mate. John. Johnny Ray.
John Ray.
Johnny Ray. Nature TV.
Okay.
Speakers Corner London.
What's it called here?
Nature TV London.
Nature TV London.
Just do that and it'll be on there. Nice one. Cheers, mate. I'll see you again next time. Are you down in London all the time there?
I live in London, but I don't always come here.
Yeah.
Just like to come see somebody in central London, so I thought, let me come and have a little tickle here. It's quite interesting. Yeah. I like to talk to learned ones.
Of course. Yeah.
No point talking to anybody else, because again.
And we can pick up on each other, and he's a good talker.
Yeah, he's a very good talker.
Like yourself.
Yeah.
Therefore, okay, so that's right. We have certainly sent it down in Arabic Quran so that you can understand. So in other words, in order for us to understand the Quran, what language must we use according to the Quran? Yeah. Arabic.
Because they were Arabs that came to.
Okay, fine.
But Allah knew in his great plan it's going to trouble the world.
So you're right. But now I'm saying to you, you're absolutely right. So we have to use the principles of Arabic in order to understand this verse. Okay. We're not, no hadith. Please. Don't tell me anything about hadith. I'm making it so clear. I'm putting the hadith to the side now.
Only if that was true.
Don't say that, because it's annoying. I'm saying no hadith, yeah? And I'm not using any hadith here. I'm saying, was Qurna, first word, talking to the woman, the wives of the Prophet, and mention, ما يتلى في بيوتكم, whatever is mentioned in your homes, من آيات الله, from the ayat of Allah, والحكمة, and the hikmah, which is the wisdom.
Yeah.
Okay.
I agree with that.
Now, in Arabic, I've said to you before, when the well, it's a letter, well, it's a conjunctive letter, yeah? It puts two things which are different from each other next to each other. You cannot say two things are the same and put them two together. It doesn't work in Arabic. It doesn't even work in English. You can't say Cameron and Cameron went to the park. It just doesn't make any sense.
Unless it's two different cameras.
Yeah, unless it's two different cameras, right?
I agree with you. We're coming back to the same part of what I said to
please,
you before.
Please.
You can only get
this. Let me finish, please. You've got to now, because the Quran, now it's going to come to you, either accept or reject it. Now, if I say, I was riding a bike in a bike, does that make sense?
No, okay, fine. Let's talk about the Quran.
Okay, I'm saying, even in English it doesn't make sense, let alone Arabic.
No, talk about the Quran.
Fine. So here, there's an instruction from Allah to the women who are the wives of the Prophet to recite the ayat of Allah, which are the verses of Allah, and recite something else. We'll mention something else.
No, translate it word for word.
Wath Qurna.
No, Arabic, not Arabic, English.
Wath Qurna, word for word. Wath Qurna, and you women folk, ما يطلع, what is recited, في بيوتكنا, in your houses, من آيات الله, from the ayat of Allah, والحكمة, and the wisdom.
And the wisdom.
Okay.
And this is where we disagree now.
Okay, now please.
Because I said
what
to
I'm saying is
the hikmah.
But now you have to do.
Comes from the Quran.
Okay, listen. I don't disagree so far, but what I'm saying is not the same thing as the Quran.
This is.
Okay. Now you've committed a fallacy.
No, I haven't. Because you can only get the.
That's not fair.
No, brother. You
rejected the Quran.
No, brother. I've not. Because you can only get the hikmah of the Quran. you believe in the if you believe in the oneness of Allah and you believe
I'm telling you in Arabic language it's impossible.
Forget about the language.
We're talking about hikmah here.
I'm telling you, for you to get the hikmah of the Quran, you have to believe in every word that is said in there, and you have to apply it. And when the Creator when the Creator says that this is the book that's going to guide you to heaven, and you're going to follow the footsteps of the Prophet, and you believe in the unseen, that everything in this book is here, you believe in that, then you'll get the hikmah from the Quran, then the wisdom will come. The wisdom will come.
I can't do this.
Because I'm not a Christian.
Forget about Arabic, even though you're using a translation.
No, because you're trying to legitimize understanding your hadith, because you need to understand the Arabic language.
He's talking about the hadith. He said he's using the Quran, and you're using your own idea.
In the same breath you said that the Quran is preserved, in the same breath you say, well, no, it's not preserved because you need the Arabic language.
I said, did I once say that it's not preserved?
You're saying it without saying it. That's what I'm saying.
I mean, according to you, that's what it is, but you saying that the Quran is not preserved without realizing it. That's what I'm saying.
Well done, great interview, mate.
This
well
got to be a first hand, you've run away from somewhere.
Yeah, you done well. You stood up for yourself and you backed yourself up.
Well, yeah, I know verses.
Oh, that's
you know,
fair.
They cannot, you know, it's easy for them to overpower people that have not read the scripture.
Yeah, exactly.
I've read it. They're mixing truth with falsehood. Now they're trying to legitimize their belief with more falsehood. How can you do that? Use the book itself to explain itself. Yeah. And it does that. Yeah. There'd be no trouble in the world. Muslims won't be in any trouble if they follow the scripture.
Instead of going back to
everything
else.
There'd be no Sunnis, there'd be no Wahhabis, there'd be none of this concept. Yeah, yeah. We'd be exactly the same.
With the classical.
Yeah, we just have little differences, little silly understandings.
Which is enough.
We won't be violent, we won't be aggressive, we won't be demonic, we won't be satanic, we won't be nothing negative.
Yeah, and trying to get everyone on our side to this side, putting each other around.
Absolutely.
What is your name anyway, mate?
Cameron.
Cameron, nice one. Good stuff, mate. Pleasure to meet you. Pleasure.
So I guess that you've been here for a while.
I come down and do a few films. Yeah.
So you must see quite a few battles, as they say.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, there's some good ones. Yeah, there is. You know, so Muhammad's involved in a few of them.
I know. I see him sometimes on YouTube. So what would you rank this one out of 10?
Yeah, it was a good debate. 10 out of 10 for the debate. You know, he was trying to put a few things over. You were trying to put a few things over.
He wasn't taking any notice of what I was saying. That's the feeling that I got from him.
Yeah.
Because he's quite learned.
No, he is. But when it comes up on the video, you know, and he might see it and on his own mind, then he might consider a few things later.
Yeah.
Good points that you made.
Yeah.
And he made a few good points.
Yeah.
So.
Absolutely.
It's less nice to have that mix, and then we can make a judgment.
Yeah. I look forward to it.
Nice, man. Excellent. Good stuff, Cameron. All the best to you, mate. John. Johnny Ray.
John Ray.
Johnny Ray. Nature TV.
Okay.
Speakers Corner London.
What's it called here?
Nature TV London.
Nature TV London.
Just do that and it'll be on there.